I think we can actually work directly in the console for now because we're not building anything elaborate. So let's go ahead and write some more code. We're going to be talking about Booleans in this video. So a Boolean is it's a type. Just like string and integers are types, Boolean is a type that's used for certain purposes. For instance, I mean, you can't really compare different types. Unless it's float and integer, you can compare those both as numbers. But you can't compare a Boolean like true or false to text. You can't say if text equals or if text is greater than true. Like there's no greater than true. True is just true. So let's go ahead and create a variable called I like cheese. And that's going to be set to true. Now, you'll notice that true is it's a keyword. It's a Boolean operator. So it's going to be color-coded like variable in most cases. And it's just a lowercase word. You don't put it inside text, then it becomes a string. But we're interested in using it as a Boolean. And so we can check if something equals something else by saying I like cheese equals equals true. This will return true because it does equal that. Or does it equal true in text? Now, as I said, true as a Boolean does not equal true as text because true as text is not a Boolean operator. There's no way to compare the two because they're so different. And we'll talk more about comparisons later on. I just wanted to show you guys the difference between a Boolean and a string. Now, you can also set, maybe I have a bad experience with cheese, and I don't like cheese anymore. We reassign by saying I like cheese equals false. So when you're assigning a variable or reassigning a variable, you always use one equal sign. I saw that I used two here, so I just didn't want you guys to get confused as to when to use each one. Two are used for comparisons. One is used for assignments. So now I like cheese now becomes false. These are two Boolean operators, and that's all we're covering in this video, I guess. In the next video, I think we're good to move forward to more advanced things, hopefully if conditions and for loops and stuff like that.